सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। नमः कृष्णाय शुद्धाय ब्रह्मणे परमात्मने योगेश्वराय योगाय स्वामहं शरणं गता। आपदामपहर्तारं धातारं सर्वसंपदां लोकाभिरामं श्रीरामं भूयो भूयो नमाम्यहम्। वेलकम फ्रेंड्स to another episode of my What They Don't Tell You. This aspect is of covering the hair. In all religions, beginning with Hindu religion, Islam, Christianity, Judaism, and all these religions, covering the hair has been a practice in India, in northern India. They call it Ghonghat. And everywhere they use their cloth sari to cover the head. In Christian countries they used to wear hats, and Jews also wear the hats, and Muslims wear a niqab that covers the hair. In Jewish communities even today we see they cover their head with a wig, if not with a hat. That is there. Why should we cover the head with something? Why should we cover the hair? Normally nobody tells you the reason why we should cover the hair. Even how about males? Is it restricted only to females? No. Even males have to cover their hair. And in Ramayana, while describing the city of Ayodhya, Valmiki says Namukuti Nakundali. There was no one in Ayodhya who did not have some sort of headgear and the ear ornaments. So if he has taken to that kind of description, that means we can see how important it was to cover the head and the hair. Head covering is mainly to cover the hair. Whatever be the logic, the real reason behind covering the head is the strands of hair from the head especially are likely to fall. The hair from other parts of the body rarely falls on its own. It has to be cut off or pulled out. Normally hair from your hands or legs or from your face, they do not fall out. Only from head the hair falls out. And the hair getting mixed in the food is a great sin. In Mahabharata, a scenario is described when a king feeds a Brahmin and unfortunately a strand of hair comes in the food that is fed to the Brahmin, and the Brahmin becomes so angry he curses the king. Just a strand of hair, I heard many times, if a strand of hair comes in your food, are heavens going to fall? Just take it out and throw it and continue eating with the food. Why was this considered so unholy, sinful to eat food with that has hair got mixed in it? So let us answer the question, what is hair? Hair is a part of your body and that is dead. That is why it fell out. Can we touch a dead body? Can we have a dead body in our food? Leave meat eating. That's a different question. Other than that, a whole body, dead body. Can you have an insect in your body? Insect in your food? You don't. You don't. And so that is why mixing hair in food is considered sinful and it is completely prohibited. If in a part of food a single strand of hair is there, the specification is all that food should be thrown out because it contains a dead body. And not only that, then why ghonghat or head covering or hair covering? It's because the hair can fall on the floor anywhere and you may step on it. Stepping on hair or a cut off nail is equivalent to stepping on a dead body. Stepping on a dead body of a insect or a man? Question yourself, would you like to step on the dead body? No. It is impure, unpious, and sinful. And hair especially, it is on the head of a person. By stepping on the hair, you are stepping onto the head of another person. And stepping on the head of another person is sinful. You may argue that stepping on a strand of hair is not the same as stepping on the head of another person. You may consider, so you are free. Everybody is free. Freedom is the order of the world. And everybody can have their own view. This is granted by all constitutions, free speech. But the reality and the fact is that stepping on a strand of hair or stepping on a piece of nail is equivalent to stepping on the hair, is stepping on the head, finger stepping on the hand, on the palm. Nails do not fall out, only hair falls out. That is why covering of the hair has been mandated by all religions, bar none. There is no religion that says you need not cover your hair. They think the feminization or feminists started calling it is to prevent you from exhibiting your beauty. No. That is the inference of ignorant people. The real thing is hair is on the head, and stepping onto a strand of hair is stepping onto the head of a person. That is why when somebody's hair was cut in the earlier days, when the barber used to come and cut the hair, they were sitting in a secluded corner, and immediately after the cutting is over, they were dusted off and all the hair strands from their body are cleaned down, and he goes in the house, and before he goes into the house, they used to take a bath and let the strands of hair that are still loose on his head or on the body are washed off with the hair and go away. They are disposed of just as you would dispose of a dead body. That is why the hair is covered so that the strand does not fall somewhere and it is stepped on by somebody. What do we lose if somebody else steps on it? The sin is caused by us. Whatever sin he caused is because of our negligence, our not being attentive, our not taking care of our things. That is why he stepped. So when somebody else steps on a strand of hair that has come loose off your head, the sin is as much as his for not seeing and yours for leaving it there. So hair facts, this is not simple, friends. Don't step on a strand of hair, it is sinful. And don't leave a strand of hair somewhere, it is still sinful for being negligent. So now friends, you know why covering the hair has been considered important, and some sort of headgear was always worn from ancient times. In the recent modern age of knowledge, or I would call ignorance, because we do not know the funda. We know the advanced things. We know more chemistry, more physics, and more mathematics, perhaps. But we do not know the facts of life as the ancients knew. And they documented it. That's how I come to know. But most of the people are not reading documents, ancient books, and scriptures and epics. And we are not understanding. That is why we are roaming in this manner. So friends, cover your head. If you can't cover your head, ensure that the hair strand does not fall anywhere. That is why ghongat was used. That is why naqab is used. That is why hats are used. And that is why wigs are used. Thank you friends for watching. Swasti prajabhya paripalayantam nyayena margena mahi mahisha. ओ ब्राह्मणेभ्यः शुभमस्तु नित्यं लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु।